Hi friends, welcome to the new series Angular Interview Concepts with Explanation. In this series, I'm explaining some of the concepts those are most focused on Angular interviews. If you just prepare for your Angular interview, like a question and answer format, it won't help you a lot. If the same question is asked differently, you may struggle. Instead, if you understand the core concept behind that, you will not forget forever and you can easily answer. That is what I'm trying to explain with some examples. Let's start. In Angular interviews, there may be questions regarding routing concepts. In this video, I'm going to explain the difference between using ROUTERLINK directive, navigate method, and navigateByUrl method. Also, I'm going to explain the difference between routing to relative and absolute path. To explain these concepts, I have created an Angular application in which I have two components, home and user component. In home component, I have created few links and buttons so that I can navigate to the user component using any of these. And in user component, I have a button to navigate back to home component. And I also have a service in which I am just increasing a counter. And I am showing this counter in home component. This is required to explain the need for routing. If you are not familiar with how to do routing setup, I request you to see the routing video in the Angular 0 to Hero series. I have also provided the link in the description. Okay, let's get into the concept. First of all, why do we need routing when we can simply use the href attribute? Most of us already know the answer. When we use href, the page will refresh, and so we cannot maintain the state. Let me show that. When I increase this count and move to user page using href attribute, and if I come back to home, we can see we lost the state. But if I use any of the other methods, the state is preserved, because in this case, page will not be refreshed. In Angular, we can either use the ROUTERLINK directive or we have two methods available in router, navigate and navigateByURL. Using any of these, we can achieve routing. But what is the difference between these? First, let's look into the ROUTERLINK directive. As it is a directive, we can use it in the HTML. We use this ROUTERLINK directive whenever we need to route it directly without performing any other task. And if the route path is stored in the TypeScript component in any variable, we can also bind it using the property binding syntax. But here I can directly use it like this. So when I click this link, I'll be taken to the user page. But if I want to perform any task before routing to the next page, for example, if I want to save something in the database before moving to the next page, I can use the router methods. We have two methods, navigate and navigateByURL. The difference between these two methods is the navigate method accepts an array and it constructs the route path. But navigateByURL method accepts a string where we can give the route path, like this. And using navigate method, we can also achieve relative path routing using the relative to option. But navigateByURL can be used for absolute path routing only. Let me explain the relative and absolute path routing. In home component HTML, you can see I have used a path starting with forward slash. This is absolute path. When I use this, the entire path in the URL after the domain will be replaced. And so I'll be navigating to the user page. And in user HTML also, I have used absolute path. And so I can come back to home page. Now let me remove the forward slash here. Now this is relative path. So this will not work. In error message, it is clear that it is trying to go to /1/home, which is not a valid path. So when I change it back to forward slash, it will work. Hope you understood and like this video. Please subscribe to my channel and support me. I'll be back with another concept soon. Thank you. Bye.